Are you wanting your shots just to pop a little bit more?
Check this out. This is something I do all the time, especially with interviews or whenever my subject doesn't move around too much. So you have your shot. Let's say you corrected and color graded it. Open a color wheels or a color board, hit this little icon, and click Add Shape Mask. Make an elongated oval and place it over your subject. This outside circle adds a bit of feathering. So I'll adjust that a tad to make whatever adjustments I make to the inside of the circle more gradual. Head up to your color wheels, and with the inside selected, raise the exposure slider on your highlights a little bit. The reason I raise the highlights and not the midtones is because raising the midtones usually results in you washing out your subject. Then click outside, which will allow us to make adjustments to the outside of this feathered oval, and lower your midtones a tad. And also lower your shadow slightly if you'd like. Just make sure you don't crush your blacks and go below zero on the luma waveform, or you'll lose detail in the darkest parts of your image. If you click View Masks and select Color, you can see what the inside of the mask is affecting. Now if I toggle this effect on and off, you'll see that it looks like we added a whole new lighting setup while filming. It makes quite a big difference in having your subject pop more. Aside from client work, this is also something I do in every single one of the talking head portions of my YouTube videos. I have another really cool bonus tip for you, but I wanna talk about the sponsor of this video, Color Finale, which is by far the best way to create professional color grades in Final Cut Pro. It is the absolute jam, and with a few adjustments, you can quickly create this complementary color look to create some color separation in your subject and your background. If I try to create this with the native color grading tools, this is what happens. You can group and rename layers, which is so immensely helpful for knowing which adjustment is what. You can adjust the intensity of any layer you'd like. You have the option to make smooth curves in your HSL curves. You can quickly and easily adjust specific colors in the six vectors tab. So if your skin tones are off, you just select the red color and swing the slider till your skin tone lines up on the skin tone line. You can also add sharpness that's way better than the native sharpness in FCP, and if all of that is a little too advanced for you, you can easily adjust contrast, temperature, tint, and saturation with easy to use sliders. Click the link in the description and you can try out Color Finale 2 Pro for free. So back to the video, check this bonus tip out. If I add a focus blur onto my clip, maybe I'll decrease the height so it covers the full image, create a shape mask again, click this little drop-down menu and hit Invert. Put the shape over our subject and feather it. And we'll decrease the amount a bit. Now we've created kind of a fake shallow depth of field here. Obviously it's not perfect, but it really helps to smooth over this busy background. You can also do the same thing with the sharpen effect, except don't invert it this time. So we went from this to this in a few simple steps. If you want to learn about a really helpful built-in tool that'll help you while color grading, click this video right here and have an awesome rest of your day.